Okay, so if we go to Narcissus, so I doubled my runs. I got to where I was the week before and then pushed a little further. Didn't have much luck with gear dropping. I had two, three pieces that dropped that I was able to swap out my Primalist gear. I did upgrade a couple pieces as well when I started to get into higher keys, and it seemed like things were getting just a bit more difficult. I did upgrade a couple things. So the lowest level gear I have is 411 now. And then I did make a gem for my bracers. So that's stamina and haste. So. And then if we look at. Yeah, so that's how far I got. So I was at 870 last week. So, has been my experience. First week goes pretty quick, and then the second week on is a bit of a grind, so things tend to slow down. So did manage to do a plus 9. I had to do this twice. We ran out of time on the last boss, so it didn't count, didn't show as overtime, just didn't change the ratings. So yeah, so let's go open the vault. So all three rewards will be 428. So anything should be an upgrade. If I could have done a plus 10, they would have been 431. Wasn't quite able to do that. So I want to try to find something with haste on it. That is part of the tier set. Spirit Bloom applies a heal over time effect for 40% of the healing done every 8 seconds. Dream Breath healing is increased by 15%. And I just upgraded the shoulders to their maximum. That is disappointing. I think I might go with the chest. It's the bigger upgrade, and it has haste, so I'll lose some versatility to gain haste. So I think that's, as much as I want a part of the tier set, I think the chest overall makes more sense. So, for better or worse, I'm going with it. Okay. So, I'm figuring out some things from my previous experience. So, I had gotten a chest piece. I thought it was going to be good because it had avoidance on it. However, it kind of scattered my stats. So I want to, in addition to trying to keep one set of gear as best I can, just upgrade one set or just swap out if it's a actual upgrade. Like this chest was I got from the vault. I want to try to keep my stats as condensed as possible. Critical strike, haste, mastery seems to be working, a little bit of versatility, a little bit of leech. Want to try to keep everything at least 20%. My haste had fallen. Yeah, so that's my old chest piece. So my haste had actually fallen down to 17, and then I got gloves, which got it up to 18, and then, as I said, I made a gem for my bracers that give stamina and haste. I wasn't sure what I wanted to make for this slot for sure. I like the idea of stamina. I had to level jewel crafting a bit to make this one, but this one, stamina and haste, that I liked since my haste had fallen below 20%. So 20% usually back in the day was like the threshold, so kind of using that as a somewhat of a marker. I'm also realizing, so I said haste and mastery didn't seem to do much. So haste, I said did affect like your global cooldowns, which seems to be a bit more important than I realize, especially with like Dream Breath and Emerald Blossom, things like that. It seemed like at 17% everything was just recharging so slow. So I'm going to see now that I'm back at 20% if that makes a difference or if the dungeons are just getting more difficult, and that's more what I'm noticing is I have to heal in more quick succession than I did before. Usually Dream Breath, you get your dot out, Echo, Reversion, Verdant Embrace for more like single target healing, and usually you were good. You could save, rewind, Spirit Bloom. Usually use Spirit Bloom with Tip of the Scales. Usually could save those for the boss fight. And you were good for most of the dungeon. Occasionally a DPS would die from standing in something. And then for mastery, I said last week that mastery didn't seem to have much of an effect. I also wasn't staying on top of my health. I've been making it more a priority to make sure I'm as healed as possible. Keeping a dot on myself. Kind of healing myself more like a tank. Just throwing reversion or something on just to make sure my health stays topped up. And that seems to have helped because your mastery is based on what your health is at as far as what you're healing, how much healing you'll do. So. That seems to have helped. So, all that being said,
Where's fit for the aspects?
want to try to upgrade things as much as possible so I can really push keys. So, okay, I can't upgrade you because I need a Worm Shadow Flame, which you get from 11 to 15. So I'll be able to get everything at least to what, 428. This has haste and versatility. That wouldn't be terrible. No, you need a shadow granite. Worms. Shadow flame chest as well. Okay. You I can upgrade. You have haste and mastery, so that wouldn't be terrible. So how far can I upgrade you? So I can upgrade you to. I need three of these traits. Okay.
May I serve you again?
I guess maybe that's what I should have done first, was make some friends. We'll stop at four. I'll make four of each. Wanna roughly try to keep track of what I do here, so. Okay.
The city's finest goods.
Let's upgrade this. What was it to a 424? Okay, I'm good with that. Good, good, good. And then after that, okay. So I hope everything gives worms. It says Dragonflight Mythic Dungeons, between 11 and 15. So I hope everything does. Otherwise, this is going to be quite a grind. Okay, can I do the same thing?
See all Veldrakken has to offer.
I should be able to. Okay.
Best goods in the Isles.
Critical strike and haste should be pretty good. Mastery is at 35, so I'm not overly concerned about that. I did swap out my trinkets again. That might be as good as I can do right now. The cloak. I like upgrading the cloak.
Return soon.
So, pick another one of these. How you here? Okay. How
Veldrakken quality.
How much further can I upgrade the cloak? Okay, I don't have 4. So I'll make what I do.
The city awaits.
I think I can make one more. I'm short one.
The city's finest goods.
Versatility seems pretty good, so. No. There we go. There we go. So, yeah. I'm out of Drake's Shadow of Blame Crest now, so. I think the boots were gonna allow me to use. No? No, I thought they were gonna use the older crest, so I've upgraded everything as far as I can. Okay. So I feel good about that. So, I will try those stats out.
See all Veldrakken has to offer.
I feel good about trying to increase my haste, so. Yeah. Yeah, I feel good with those. Those seem to be working really well, these stats, so. As I said, I swapped out my trinket again. I had Water's Beating Heart, which was supposed to increase armor and heal. More powerful on targets below 20% health. Just didn't really seem to help much when I used it. Usually as a healer, if you have a trinket that does some kind of a healing effect, it can... In the past, it's been really good to... have kind of an extra emergency ability, kind of a thing. So I swapped it out for Spoils of Netherius, which is supposed to increase a secondary stat. So typically on boss fights, might get a little. There's usually if you're in a good group, where everybody's geared and more or less knows the fights, you'll typically have 2 phases of whatever mechanic it is. So, the first one I can get through, usually with Rewind or, Yeah, Tip of the Scales and then Spirit Bloom. The second one can be kind of tricky. So I was thinking sometimes having a bit of extra, increasing your stats a bit may not be terrible. And depending on what boss it is, you'll have Hero for the first mechanic, but chances are not the second. It's worn off by then. So yeah. So there you go, folks. Hope you enjoyed that, and thank you for watching.